If you don't mind, let's begin with a word of prayer. Dear Father in heaven, we praise you and thank you for the many blessings you have given us. Tonight, we thank you especially for the gift of living in a free constitutional republic in which we can participate in our government, regardless of the result. For we know, Lord, that the result is in your hands. Jeremiah 14:22 says, "Is it not you alone, O Lord, our God, to whom we look? You alone have done all these things." We ask forgiveness for the times when we have taken your blessings for granted. And we ask that you heal us and our nation, Lord, for you know our nation is in trouble. And we ask these things in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Amen.
I would like to, first of all, congratulate James Lankford on his victory this evening. He won because he had an awesomely loyal network of people through his church and because he worked very hard and very skillfully to inspire his network to get involved and to vote and volunteer. And that is very commendable. Networking is the very basis of politics. He deserves it. He has my support. I wish him well. And I will continue to pray for him and his family. We worked hard too. And we would have deserved it if we had won. There aren't a whole lot of things I would have done differently. There's a few, but not that many. And I don't think that if we'd done things differently, that it would have made a big difference. I'd like to thank each and every one of you from the bottom of my heart for your support, your encouragement, your hard work, and your prayers. You know, when we started on this, nearly 18 months ago, Tony and I discussed it. And that was before this little guy came along, or even knew he was going to come along. But it's been a calling for us to embark upon this campaign. And that calling was to work hard and to offer that work on this campaign up to the Lord as an offering to him. The result is always in his hands. So I have poured out everything into this race because that was my calling. I'm confident that I've done what the Lord wanted me to do. This is not a time for bitterness or regret or what if. This is a time for celebration of what it means to serve one's country within a calling from God. The Lord has something different in mind for Tony and us now. I don't know what that is. But it has always been my honor to serve, whether it was in the state legislature, in the military, at my church, or just as a good husband, father, and neighbor. It is in these latter roles that I look forward to now. I also look forward to a continued bond between us, those of us here today, a bond of patriotic conservatism, of love of country in the coming years. And so, on behalf of Tony and myself, once again, may God bless you and God bless America. Thank you.